Hello, now what we are going to do is to add a template to our project because, for example, if we run this application, we are going to do it. In order to do that, just simply click here and then click on the run button to start running our application. This is what it does, is to compile everything, okay, and shows here a web browser with the application running. As you can see, there is nothing because we doing nothing. The only is about the title for this project, and in order to change it, what we can do is to edit the HTML for the project that is named is named index.html. Okay, this is the index.html file, and here on the title section, here it is. This is the title, so we are going to change it to remote jobs.s.es. Okay, now if we run again, and now I'm going to use the keyboard because usually it's faster, and in order to run the application is F5. I'm going to do it, it's not going to work, and let me explain you why. If I press F5, okay, nothing happens. Why? Because it's already running. Okay, this is the debug toolbar. Our project is already running, so we need to stop it before run again. In order to do that, you can simply press Shift F5, okay, it's a stop, and now press F5 again, and our application, okay, is compiled and run again. As you can see, now we have the title, okay. So one of the nice things of working with this kind of technology is about the templates. We are in the web world, so what we are going to do is to show. There is a nice, I'm going to close this. I'm going to get this here. Okay, here on the desktop, I have a template that I have downloaded from the internet. Okay, and then just to show it to you. Okay, this is the template, and it's a template for a job listing website. And the template or the page I'm interested on is this one, Browse Jobs. Okay, this is the one that we are going to be working. And this is a static template. Okay, it's nice because it's responsive and all that. But in any case, it's a static template. And what we are going to do with TMS Web Core is to show information live there. Okay, as you can see, it's responsive. Okay. So how can we do that? Well, the first thing is to get the HTML page. This is the one that is the Browse Jobs that I'm interested. So what we are going to do is to open it on Visual Studio Code. Okay, this is the HTML template. I'm going to close the terminal. Okay, so in order to get this template inside my application, I simply select everything and I copy all the contents into the HTML for my pass file, for my unit, okay? Every unit has a Pascal file, an HTML, and a DFM. So in this case, this is the HTML for that unit, and what I'm going to do is to delete everything and paste here all the contents, okay? So now what I can do is to run my application. It's not going to work. I'm doing this on purpose in order for you to see these kind of issues that are pretty normal. So now let's run this application and let's see what happens. Okay, as you can see, there are contents, but those contents are not shown as expected. Why? Because you know, usually templates have a list of assets that they need to be copied with the project. For example, there are scripts, there are images, there are fonts, there is CSS, okay? So what I'm going to do is to copy all these, okay? All these four items into the source folder for my application. I'm going to paste them, okay? So now if I switch now to the form designer and I refresh that template, just make a simple modification here, Okay, now I'm getting that template inside my form designer live. Okay, and I can resize, and it's responsive, okay, because this is the real thing. This is like a web browser that is showing you the template that you can work on it. So it's very nice to see the result of your application inside the form designer. And now I'm going to execute, and it's not going to work. Again, this is on purpose for you to see how this works. Okay. So, well, first stop, and then run again. Okay, and I'm getting the same results. Why? Because the tool doesn't know that those files, the CSS, the fonts, the images, belong to the project. Okay. So, in order to add them to the project, what I'm going to do is to simply right-click there on the folder I want to add, and then add to the project. Okay. Then I do the same for fonts. I'm going to click here and then add to the project. The same for images, add to the project. And the same for scripts, add to the project. Okay. From the moment those files, I'm going to close everything to the right. Since the very moment those files are added to the project, okay, every time I run my application, are deployed to the output. Okay, so now when I run, okay, now works as expected, because those files, okay, are copied to the output. Where is the output? Let's see here. Okay. The output is on TMS Web debug, the debug configuration, which is what I'm working on. Okay. So now I have inside the debug all the CSS, font, images, all that. And I can safely delete this folder. Okay. We'll do that later, because that is not considered part of my source code. Okay. It's the output of my project. So you should never add any file that you want to keep on that folder. You should always work on the source folder and add anything that you want to add to the project. Okay. So also, as you can see now, these files are like considered for the SCM. Okay, here. Okay. So what I'm going to do is to edit again the gitignore file and remove TMS Web folder, because this is not part of my application, but the rest of files are considered part of my application. And I'm going to make a commit, added templates, and then commit all. Okay. So, in short, what we have right now is we have added the template to our project, so it looks as it should be. I can resize it here. And we have added those files to the project, so every time I run and deploy my application, are copied to the right folder. Okay, so that's it. Thank you.